Earth, and they're in the different countries, and they get the earthquake theater stuff going, where they're all making contact with each other on the computers, and they start tracking the earthquakes and stuff. But if something does happen in 2012 or 2013 or beyond, then, you know, in that era, you know, when we're going through the galactic plane, because in at that particular time, the Earth is supposed to be going through the galactic plane of our galaxy in the Milky Way. And, you know, when you're, let's say, there could be possible something, it could be the pole shifting or something of that sort, or just a minor change or something that could do something to our Earth that we're not aware of yet. But according to the Mayan calendar, at these different dates in the past, something did happen at the different time periods, those different eras, that the era that we're coming into. And that's why everybody needs to get together now and figure this stuff out now and get it rolling, so that everybody can be aware of what's happening in the future. If there's ever a continent going under, you know, or coming up or something like that, then people will be able to move away from there. They'll be able to get in their cars or get on planes or whatever, and the countries will have mass evacuations if need to be, just like they would the cities today. You know, if there was a need to get away from the cities, that's the only way they're going to be able to know it in time, you know. And that's why everybody will have to stick together, you know. And then you really don't have to trust your government, you know. If you've got this stuff, you know, there's going to be the underground people, that's like the underground weather people that have their own weather stations going all over, you know. So you don't have to trust the government with this kind of stuff. You can have it, you know, you can see it, it's real, and you learn how to do it, and I can help you learn later on or whatever you need to do. But, and there's another thing, you know. You know, when I can see this stuff, when I fire this stuff up, and I can see this thing in the distance, and I can see the dam over here that time, and it's like a beacon in the sky, you know. I've decided that this must be why the birds, like homing pigeons and stuff like that, and certain animals are able to find their way home, because they can see this stuff with their own eyes. Even though we don't know they can see it, they can see it. And it's like a homing beacon out there piercing up into the sky. And even some of the satellites have actually seen some of this stuff. And there have been people that have actually photographed this stuff with their regular cameras over there in China. They had some people that photographed it piercing up in the air, pulsing into the air. They were at an angle. I don't know what angle they were, but I suspect it was like a 45-degree angle from what I was looking at on the internet, on the YouTube pictures of it. And that's what I think the homing pigeons and stuff like that, they see these giant beacons in the air, and they use them as beacons to find their way home and stuff like that. And for people that are interested in saving the whales when they beach themselves, all these whales and porpoises and stuff like that beach themselves before these gigantic earthquakes strike, you know, these massive ones. And then there's sometimes that they beach themselves before, or sometimes they beach themselves when there is no massive earthquake. Well, I think what happens when there is no massive earthquake is that it's a massive link that's released. That's what I think. Or it's some pretty good size link that is released, and that's why there was no earthquake there. But what these whales and these porpoises seeing in the water, they could see it, and that's what I'm thinking they saw was the same thing that I can see when I fire up this equipment. I can see it, but they can probably see it better than I can. You know, they don't need equipment to fire it up. They go ahead and they can see it with their own eyes. And then somehow it disturbs them, and somehow they swim towards it or whatever. They swim away from it, more than likely. They probably swim away from it. And when they swim away from it, they're trapped up on the beach, but they're terrified of it. You know, it's just my guesstimate, you know, of what I come up with, my theory about the whales and the birds and stuff. But I think that's pretty correct. So if you want to save the whales and stuff like that in the future, you know, you're gonna get this equipment. Your people are going to get out there and you're going to use it, or get other people that want to use it. You know, you're going to have them go out and do it. It'd be like the big safari game hunt. You know, you get your guide to go out and do it because he can get you there. So you get those people, you get out there and you find where they're at, and then you can be there waiting along the coastline. You can have different people waiting at different intervals looking for these pilot whales and these other whales to come in to beach themselves. You can already be there. You can save their lives. So that's how that works. You've got a chance to be there ahead of time and to save their lives. And so going back to the 212 stuff, you know, you can find the safe areas. There's a lot of people out there right now in different countries that are saying, pay me like a million pounds or whatever. There's that one guy that's on the internet, pay me a million pounds and I'll get you in with my group and we'll be in a safe area. You know, when 2012 comes, we'll be ready for it, you know. And I'm telling you, these people, they don't have a clue. Anywhere in the world, they don't have a clue where a safe area is. The only place that you're going to know where there is a safe area right now is if you use this equipment, because you will know exactly where there is no pressure in the ground. That is very safe. But when there starts being pressure in the ground, and it gets huge over, the pressure gets huge over a massive area, well, you better be ready to do something, because that's the time when it's going to, there could possibly be something, and you got to know where the links are that are going to give you the time and the day that's going to be happening. Just like over here when I was doing the coastal stuff with the California and stuff, you know, it's 72 hours, you know. You're talking about, well, that's 3 days away out there. So once it releases in Wichita and goes up to California, you know, they got 72 hours, you know. Can you always trust the government to tell you you've got that 72 hours? No, they're not going to tell you that stuff probably in the beginning, you know, until a bunch of people go out and do it on their own, you know, because they're going to wait and try to have you mess up or whatever, but you're not going to mess up with this stuff because you're going to see how this stuff really works. And it's just like I've told you, especially in that other video, it's all exactly like that, you know, and even in this video, it's just like this, but that one there was more detailed on how it was. So you probably want to watch that. And if you get the equipment, then that's how you do it. You go in and you do it just like I showed you in that video. But I can't think of anything else at the moment.